Hello everyone, this is Chandika. Today I'm going to brief you about plant leaf disease prediction using deep learning. Before getting into this topic, please like and subscribe my channel and then follow the Instagram link below. So, without any further discussion, let me quickly walk you through an agenda. We will start this session by understanding the introduction, block diagram, and we will discuss about tools and Python packages used in this project. Finally, I will end this session by working on demo and with a practical session. Isn't it amazing? Here is an introduction. Most of the countries depends on agriculture. India is an agriculture country. And then crop production is one of the major source of earning. Due to lack of factors like diseases, pest attacks and sudden change in weather conditions, the productivity of the crops has been decreased. Farmers are using visual techniques for the prediction of diseases, which is not accurate. However, to overcome all these problems, automatic prediction of leaf is essential to detect the symptoms. We are using convolution neural network to train the disease automatically, which can be deployed in real time. Here is a block diagram, workflow of plant leaf disease prediction. The first one is data set creation, which has three patterns: train, test, and validation. And now, for this prediction, I have selected tomato leaf. You can use other leaves as well. And in the data set folder, we have test, train, and validation. In the train folder, we have different kinds of diseases. In each folder consists of different images. Train and validation is used for training model. Next one is CNN design, convolution neural network. It helps to detect the color image and more number of classifications. Next one is pre-processing. It helps in processing the data and train the model. We are going to load model to test, and the input is pre-processed for deploying the normal image classification. Here we go for the demo, the most awaiting moment. And this is a web application to predict tomato leaf disease and to get the cure. Let's select the file. Here I'm gonna select any leaf. Let's select image one and then predict. Oh, this is a healthy and fresh leaf. Here we go and select another leaf. Could be nine, and then say open and then predict. This is a leaf, tomato leaf, having a disease, two spotted spider mite disease, and this is a cure to treat this disease. Before getting into the practical session, please download the below link to get the code from the GitHub details. Here is a practical session by using Python. First one is training the model. After downloading the code from the GitHub, here is a requirements.txt file, and these are the Python packages. Let's install the Python packages using command prompt. And this is the code to install the packages. I have already installed the packages. I'm not going to install it again. Now open this training.py file. These are the Python libraries. And These are the training set of images which is stored in the training set. These are the validation set of images which is stored in valid set. By using epoch, we are going to train the model. After training the model, the file is saved as model.h5. Now we are going to test the model with an example. Now open example.py. These are the libraries. And now we are going to load model.hy file and we are going to test a single image and we are going to run the code. Model is loaded successfully and this is the result. Now we are going to create web application using Flask. Select this line. This is the code and then we are going to run this code. Copy this link. Paste it here. And this is the web application. Choose the file and select any image in this and say open and predict. This is a healthy and fresh leaf and there are no diseases on the tomato leaf. We are going to, let's predict another leaf. Again, choose the file, select any image, see open and then predict. Oh, this is a tomato mosaic virus disease and this is the cure for this disease. We are going to host web application in AWS cloud. Select AWS console. And your AWS management console. So log in with your credentials. Since I have already logged in, I'm going to use it directly. So let us create instance. So here we select EC2. Select instance and launch instance. These are the servers and then ensure that you're going to select free trial eligible one. So I'm going to select Microsoft Windows Server 2019. Here I select free trial eligible. And ignore configure instance, add storage, add tags. You can directly go to configure security group. Here you can add rule, select custom TCP and in port range enter 8080. Again add the rule, select all traffic and the source select 0 and then review and launch. Again launch, review, launch, select, create a new key pair, download key pair, enter the name and download. Again launch the instance. Then view the instance. Now the instance has been installed successfully and now let's connect. And here we go, connect. Select RDP client. Download remote desktop file. Get the password, browse, select this file and password, select here, password is copied and open downloaded remote desktop file, say connect, and paste the password. Say OK. And yes. This is initializing. You can say yes. Go to Windows, select Windows Security. Here you select firewall and network protection, and here advanced setting. Minimize, and here you have to enable this options in domain profile. Private and private profile is active, and in public profile. And select Windows Defender firewall properties. And here go to inbound connections in domain profile, and you can allow here. And again go to private profile, inbound connections, allow. Again profile, inbound connections, allow. Say apply and OK. And everything is enabled here. Install the Chrome in the cloud server and get the code to the cloud server. Say open. And select the file. Open. And here is the code. And you can run the code here. We have successfully installed the web application in the cloud server, and this is the link which can be accessed anytime from any part of the world. Now let us run the application, and here choose the file, select, and then we can predict. And this is a tomato yellow leaf curl virus disease, and this is the treatment for this disease. And again we can choose the file, select another image, say open, predict. And this is also another kind of a disease, and here is the cure for the same. We have finally concluded the practical session, and I would like to end this practical session with a proverb. Never stop learning, because life never stops teaching. And I would like to thank you all for your valuable time. If you have any queries, you can write to the below mentioned email ID. Thank you.